We have Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. Mayor Isko, before I ask you about the changes sa traslasyon this year, just very quickly, no, I know that you were asking for an investigation with the alleged mass vaccination in Binondo. Is there any solid information on that already?
Well, Karen, as an update, the day that it was nabalita na nagbabakuna dyan sa Binondo, we send our team. Sa awa naman ng Diyos, walang natagpuan at wala nang umiikot na balita. But rest assured that the city government will never ever tolerate those individuals. We'll put them to jail if they will continue doing so because it is illegal. Now, under our rules, no, FDA rules, all products, like in this case, vaccine, must be submitted before the Office of the Food and Drug Administration. Even though kahit EUA lang ang makuha nila, they have to submit themselves or those company. So I will not tolerate anybody to gain economically because ang napapabalita dyan, Karen, ano, no, kung babayad ng 20 mil, 30 mil, tapos hindi mo pa alam, baka placebo pa yung ibinibigay.
Yes.
But mind the people, no? Let me take this opportunity in the ANC, mga kababayan. Kapag ka kayo, halimbawa, the so-called bakuna ng vaccine ay bakuna talaga at iyan ay hindi pa rehistrado at hindi pa na-certifika na safe, no? The challenge with you next time, halimbawa po, dumating na yung tunay na bakuna na sertifikado at ligtas at epesyente, no, hindi na kayo pwedeng bakunahan.
Oo,
so, kayo rin ang malalagay sa alanganin. Kaya hinihikayat ko kayo, huwag ko kayo magmadali. Inilalagay ninyo sa alanganin ang inyong katawan.
Oo, very good point there. So, what do you make of the Presidential Security Group? I interviewed General Durante and he himself said on Head Start, we vaccinated ourselves. Kami, well, kumbaga sila, they know what to do, it's in the manual daw.
Oh, I don't know their manual, I cannot speak on
the in the manual daw of the vaccine. Sinundan lang daw nila ang instructions. Pero okay, he admitted, we vaccinated ourselves.
Well, as far as we're concerned, we have not allowed, we have not encouraging, and we have not doing any vaccination in the city of Manila. So they have their own reason, good reason, and I hope they did not violate any laws in our country. Because PSG has a different rules or books that they have to follow to protect the interests of the chief executive, or the commander-in-chief, no? In this case, the president. But as of the moment, we have not been informed or anything na mayroong bakunahan na nangyagaganap dito sa lungsod ng Maynila.
But then I'm curious, no, just to ask a little more. Secretary Lorenzana, during the celebration, you were with him. I think, yes, and he himself told the press what the PSG did technically was illegal and the vaccines were smuggled. Do you believe that this merits a full investigation?
Well, if that is already a fact coming from the defense secretary, then there is no need for investigation. Cases should be filed against violators. Yan ang course of action, no? Ang investigation is nagpipishing expedition pa tayo. But if there is an acceptance already of the violation, if there is a violation, then cases should be filed to those violators. But to simplify everything, no? Because ayoko namang isda, focus muna tayo dito sa ano yung tama, anong sinasabi ng national government, saan tayo tutungo, doon tayo pupunta. Saan pumupunta ang mundo, doon din natin puntahan yung ating journey towards safety, towards bagong buhay natin after the pandemic. Hopefully soon.
Okay, now moving on to traslasyon, on January 9, of course, we did a short report on the changes. But is there anything extra you are requiring the police force, the city, to ensure this weekend?
One, thank you kay Bishop Pabilio, at thank you kay Monsignor Coronel, at sa mga pari sa simbahan, sapagkat tumugon sila sa panawagan ng pamahalang lungsod na wala muna tayong translasyon. Maraming salamat sa mga ihos no, na nakiisa na rin doon sa panawagan yaon. Now, having said that, we are trying to make available space, no, Karen. Let's be honest. Hindi yan magiging perfect na ma-police ang lahat, no, because maraming deboto sa Poong Nazareno, not only in Manila but Metro Manila and some portion of the provinces or nearby provinces. Now, we made the space available, La Plaza Miranda, Villalobos, Hidalgo, Carriedo, and maybe portion of Quezon, no? Yang mga area na yan, so that we can spread. Now, who will police? Maraming magpo-police, no? Through the leadership of General Francisco, he is properly guided already by the city government and with the EHOS volunteers and MPPB and church officials, no? Ipupulis natin yung labas. Kasi sa loob, kaya ako pinagpapasalamat sa simbahan, hindi naman nagbabiolate yung simbahan. In fact, Karen, the church will issue mask and face shield. We provided them so that they can share it to their parishioner or yung mga pupunta sa loob ng simbahan. But having said that, ako mananawagan lang ako, Karen, ha, please, hanggat maari, stay na lang muna kayo sa bahay. And let's just pray solemnly to Jesus, no? Merong way.
Okay, tanong ko lang, may inaresto po ba kayo for fire crackers violation this year?
Well, Karen, again, salamat sa Diyos at salamat sa mga taga Maynila.
Wala.
Tumugon sila sa panawagan namin. Alam mo, nag-monitor talaga ako sa ibabaw ng building. I think I can honestly say, no, ito personal ko, no, about 90% of the city hindi talaga nagpaputok. On top of the situation in the field wherein all colonels or the precinct commanders were directed by General Francisco to be present in the community. Maraming umikot na police. At ang liit na halos ng minuscule yung insidente na as mga mahihinang klase pa yung insidente. So napakababa ng insidente at halos walang nagpaputok sa Maynila. Kaya maraming salamat sa mga taga-lungsod at nakatipid kayo ng pera. At least yung pera na yan may handa natin in the first quarter of this year.
All right. Now, moving on to the Pulse Asia survey. I know you've already said in interviews a few days ago, but then, of course, I can't resist the question. So you've already said no to the 2022 presidential race, but let me move it to another field. Yes, you are focusing on the pandemic. Kitang-kita naman yon with everything that you are doing. Let's start first with something simple in the survey. In the Senate race, you topped that Senate race survey. Is the Senate something you're even interested in? I mean, some people are made to be, you did run before.
Yes.
Is that something you would be open to doing again, considering now you're the mayor of Manila? I mean, before when you ran, you were not vice mayor even, if I remember, no? You were out of office, I think.
No, I'm vice mayor. Incumbent vice mayor.
Incumbent then. Ka po noon, oo. Hindi ko na matandaan nun, but I interviewed you for that. And malaking sugal po yun sa inyo kasi ginamit po ninyo Dumagoso. But you didn't fare too badly. Were you 14 or 16? 2015 ba to?
15.
Yes. Yeah. So, is the Senate at this point first something that's even in your heart?
Okay. To be fair with you, Karen, and to your viewers, lahat kami nangangarap maging senador, maging vice president and president.
Okay.
Yes.
Kumbaga pwede.
Ayoko naman maging plastikado.
Oo.
Lahat yan possible. And these things may happen. But as I have said, ayan ay tadhana. Now, that's why I don't really entertain as much as possible because this is not an ordinary days to deny those things. This there's still pandemic. Kumbaga, ang point ko lang, Karen, ayoko maiparamdam sa tao na mas atat yung mga taong politikong katulad ko na for their political growth, no, career growth, no? Mas interesado silang lumaki yung kanilang pwesto kaysa mag-focus doon sa pandemyang kinakaharap ng mamamayan. I think it's quite unfair to the people. So that's why I'm just trying to focus myself. But don't get me wrong, these are the things na pangarap ng lahat ng politiko, including me. Ano yan, nasa, anong tawag dito?
Nasa likod ng utak.
Oo, Karen, ayoko naman maging plastikada sa mga viewers mo. But again and again, it is on my daily thing, no, sa buhay ko, hanggat hindi natin nairaraos ang pandemyang ito, I think we can suppress and we can delay our goals or career goals in life. And at ako naniniwala ako dyan, ang dami na ganda dyan, Karen, Olat. Di ba?
Yeah.
Kumbaga, it's there now. But don't get me wrong. Let me take this opportunity. Anyway, tinanong mo na rin. Maraming salamat po sa mga bumoto doon sa survey. Maraming salamat. It's an honor. Thank you very much. Privilege and honor na mapili po ninyo ako. Pamisa-misa, number one sa president, number two sa president, number one sa vice president o senator. Kung ano mang posisyon niya, maraming salamat sa inyo for your appreciation. But hayaan po niyo muna, let me focus on the vaccination process. Let me focus on how are we going to keep you safe? And let me focus on how can I give you peace of mind while you're in Manila or while working in Manila. At the very least that I can do is to really acquire the end or the solution to the problem. Because what we're doing since March up to December 31 or up to today is just managing it. We have not given solution to the problem. Mm-hmm. We're just managing this growth, the so-called growth or exponential growth. So we must continue to manage it because infection is inevitable. It will continue to be there. But it has to be suppressed para hindi mabulunan yung mga ospital at hindi maapektuhan yung mga medical frontliners.
Okay,
so,
now,
yun yung goal natin, Karen.
I agree with you completely. And, well, just to expound on this, the Senate isn't as much as destiny for you as the presidency or VP, for example, because the Senate is something they're 12. They're essentially people vote for 12. You're very popular, so that's more of a choice on your end, right?
Pero Karen, mahalaga ang Senado. Sa totoo lang.
Of course, no, that's a given.
Batas, sa totoo lang yung paggawa ng batas.
That's a given.
Especially nowadays, yung pandemic, yung how fast the legislative body can act on the
matter.
Hindi
ko po sinasabing hindi siya mahalaga. I'm just saying, on your end. Being number one and people voting for 12 would be more of a decision mentally for you and a heart decision whether or not you'd leave Manila. But the higher posts, for example, and I asked Manny Pacquiao this, and okay. He says what he would want is to actually wait. He wants to hear the Lord tell him that you should run. I'm curious, what are the factors for you? Is it your family? Is it, I don't know, what will it take for an Isko Moreno to make that big leap? Because you do have critics also saying he's too young, he's only had one term, galingan pa niya, di ba? Si Pangulong Duterte had so many years in Davao, so you do have both. But what would be the tipping point for an Isko Moreno to make such a big decision?
Juan, Karen, let me contextualize my presence in the city government. No? I've been serving the people for 22 years, half of my life.
Tama.
I'm 46 now. I'm going to be 23 years in public service. Mm-mm. I started yung pinakamabab, Kusihar. 9 years, vice mayor, 9 years. And when I lost the 2016 senatorial race, thanks to the President Duterte, I was put back into public service in the National Executive Branch of Government, being the chairman of an GOCC and at the same time Undersecretary of Department of Social Welfare and Development.
Yeah.
So it's been there for 23 years, no? More or less. No. So kung yung edad ko, it's just that I am fortunate and I'm grateful to Tondo because they elected me as the youngest councilor ever elected in the city of Manila at the age of 23. Then at the same time, so on and so forth. No, yung matagal. It took me a while.
Yeah.
And I tried to prepare myself, Karen. Alam mo naman, nag-upisa ako sa gobyerno. High school mm-hmm. finish lang ako. So I really have to prove and tell and acquire some knowledge and some proper education, no?
Yeah.
Sa awa naman ng Diyos, no? But having said that, in fact, kaya hindi ko masasagot yung tanong mo kasi hindi ko pa nga siya nai-entertain.
Mm.
Masyado lang akong alam mo kabado because, Karen, you know who suffered in the city of Manila? 24,000 people ang nalagay sa panganib. 700 plus, Karen, died.
Mm.
And people
with
are
COVID.
Dying.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, Karen. Alam mo yung bawat buhay ng tao.
Oo.
It disturbed
so,
me.
Yes.
Every day. But that is filled up in my mind.
Yeah.
And
so what would be a barometer then? I'm this is the last. Is it prayer? Is it people of Manila saying go? Is it the survey? What would it be then?
Well, again and again, for purposes of practicality and for purposes of conversation. One, it's always about the numbers. That's political. You know, any politicians would agree with me. You have to have numbers. That's one.
It's where people would want you. Yeah.
Of course, kasi hindi ka naman maaring magaling pero hindi ka naman electable.
Mm.
Oh, di ba? What's the purpose of running just for the sake of running? Two, you must have a vision. You must be sure. You really have to offer something different from the others.
Mm.
That's very important. And three, what are your reasons? No, ano ba yan? Mamanahin lang ba yan? O dahil gusto ko lang lumaki ang career ko? O so on and so forth. Maraming reason. And there must be a valid reason in the eyes and ears of our people. Because nowadays, feeling ko, ito, maraming magpa-participate sa 2022. Then you have to consider your family. Are you ready? Are they ready? I'm grateful to my family dahil as you all know, nakikinig naman sila sa akin. Walang miyembro ng pamilya ko ang pinayagan kong sumali sa politika. As I have promised you a few years ago, I made that commitment to you in your show. We were in Mother... ano yung sa,
I'm here. I'm in Mother Ignacia.
Mother Ignacia. I was in Mother Ignacia then. I made a commitment to you that I will not ask my family to join because I don't believe that ang pwesto namamana. I don't believe ang pwesto pinapasa. No? Kaya gusto kong patunayan nyo sa iyo na yan ay pinagpapasalamat ko naman sa pamilya ko at nakikinig sila sa akin na walang nagpa-participate sa kanila.
Okay.
Then, of course, on top of all these things, well, I need... sometimes you have to talk to God. Of course, you really have to ask for signs and all other things because presidency is destiny. Look at President Duterte. Look at him, di ba? He's a mayor of 1,000, one of the 1,600 plus mayors. Then he became president, and good for him. Nabigyan siya ng ganong pagkakataon because not everybody will be given a chance. So those are the things that has to be considered by anybody.
Ba-a.
No, anybody who will assume or wanted to assume that those office.
Okay.
Are you true to your words, no? And kasi maraming itatanong, like you, ikaw for example,
okay.
Karen, pagdating ng araw, magtatanong
Mayor.
Ka rin sa mga kandidato. And your question is the same question ng mga tao, Maya.
Okay. Mayor, very quickly before we go, a text just came in now and said, can you please ask Mayor Isko kung dapat rin tanggalin na sa trabaho si Secretary Francisco Duque?
One, I don't have an authority to fire him. Two, ito yan, no? Changing guards in the middle of the ball game doesn't help. Now, what we should do?
Yeah. So the president should not replace him.
Hindi, kasi ganito yan, Karen. Ako, marami kaming palpak din, ha. Don't get us wrong. Ang dami naming uncertainties na nakasalamuha at marami kaming tinry. At nung try namin nag-fail kami, we didn't stop. We innovated immediately. And I think that same perspective should be adopted by any John Doe and Mary who are in the government, who move on kaagad, mag-fast track sa kilos. Pag nag-fail, then scrap it, move to another policy, another program, another approach. Pag nag-succeed, innovate, go further. yakapin mo as many as possible. Mm-hmm. So I don't think that changing things like it's like a basketball. Let me put that in retrospective. Coach, sa gitna ng laban, baka magka-leche-leche. At mas marami pa ulit magpa-practice. So why not utilize those individuals who are already there in the beginning, in the middle, and let anuan na lang ba, gabayan, tulungan, magkaisa na lamang tayo. Yun ang akin. Ano? But then again, it is up to the president. I have no authority over him.
All right. On that note, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, thank you so much for being our guest the first Monday of 2021. So God bless you. You stay strong, sir. Thank you.
Hey, Karen, pwedeng manawagan?
Go ahead.
Okay, so mga taga Maynila, help us help you. Help us to be efficient. Please try to pre-register at www.manilacovid19vaccine.com. This will help us assess and we can immediately address you as soon as dumating yung bakuna sa lungsod ng Maynila o sa Pilipinas for that matter. Maraming salamat sa inyo.
Thank you.
Diyos, makakaraos din tayo. Ingat lang.
Ingat po. Thank you. Happy New Year, sir.